The top of the draft in past years has been mostly dominated by one-and-done freshmen, as they showed their potential throughout the year, and scouts projected their ceiling to possibly become the next big thing in the NBA. There isn't usually a player over the age of 20 who is considered for a top 3 pick since I can remember. This year, with such an underwhelming freshman class, there could be a 22-year-old prospect from a mid-major that could crash the party in the top 3 in this year's draft. Dayton forward Obi Toppin. His rise to the top has been similar to Ja Morant's. To say Toppin is a late bloomer will be an understatement. He wasn't highly recruited coming out of high school. In fact, he only played varsity for 1 year in upstate New York for Ossining High School. He was a 6'2 point guard as a junior and grew 3 inches by the end of his senior year. He did not receive any D1 offers, so he wound up playing at a prep school in Baltimore for 1 year. He signed with Dayton in 2017, but he had to sit out a year because he was academically ineligible. By the time he hit the floor at Dayton, he had grew to 6'9". As a redshirt freshman, Toppin led the team in scoring with 14 points per game and was fourth in the nation shooting 67% from the field. He took that confidence and brought it right into an amazing sophomore season. For someone who didn't dunk in high school, he really gets a lot of joy jumping as high as he can and throwing it down with authority. In the first 5 minutes of his college career, he had already dunked the ball 3 times. Dayton hasn't seen a player become an All-American since Jim Paxson in 1979. Toppin will most definitely become the 10th player in Dayton's history to become an All-American after this season, but he could become the first player in school history to win the Best Individual Award in college basketball, the National Player of the Year Award. Toppin averages nearly 20 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists, 1 steal, and 1.5 blocks per game, while shooting 63% from the field and 36% from 3. Dayton currently ranks 6th in the nation with a 21-2 record, and their 2 losses were decided in overtime and were lost by a combined 8 points. Their ranking is the highest it's ever been since December of 1967. His athleticism jumps out immediately, but he's more than just a dunker. He has good touch around the rim and can step outside and knock down a 3-ball. He is also a good enough passer to make quick decisions as he rolls to the basket. His low post game has been effective in the Atlantic 10 Conference, but there are questions on if he'll be able to score with consistency in the post on the next level. But he is a tireless worker. His ability to switch between the 4 and the 5 makes him an ideal piece for a contender in the era of positionless basketball. Toppin has caught the attention of NBA scouts, and probably a month ago, he was projected as a lottery pick. But should he be in consideration for a top 3 pick? With the explosive finishes, shooting potential, and consistency, Toppin has become the safest prospect in the draft. With such a low number of big men considered in the top 10, and with so many guards that could be drafted in the lottery, Toppin could end up being drafted higher than expected. He is probably the most NBA-ready prospect in this draft, and teams in the top 10 may choose security over risk, especially in this draft. There are a lot of teams at the bottom who really don't need another 19-year-old prospect. There's no great prospect that could change the franchise in this draft. There's no Zion, and there's no Ja Morant. Why not take a solid prospect who may not be a number one option, but could be an impact player on a championship contender? And there's no reason to believe he won't continue to improve his game, even at his age.